sign on. Support small streams.
It's someone say something.
Twitch.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Knerds of the Ottoman Empire, episode Ocean's 11.
All right. You're down a man today, so it's Ocean's 3, actually.
Yeah, yeah. And then the sequel's going to be Ocean's 12, like that really shitty George Clooney movie.
It wasn't that bad. The Ocean's movies were all pretty...
They were decent.
Pretty fun.
Yeah,
they
yeah.
They were fun.
I think 13 was a little too much, though.
I just like the one with the dancing laser dude. That's all I care about.
Yeah?
The dancing... Oh, the Asian dude.
Is he
with
Asian?
The broken arm.
Is he Asian?
I think it was the Asian dude. The dude that, like, he was, like, kind of gymnastic
a,
dude.
He was a criminal, and he, broke into the place, and they had the laser show thing, the security system, and he cut the music on his iPod, and he, like, danced through the...
Laser. Yeah, yeah, that was the Asian dude.
Are you sure was Asian? I don't think he was Asian.
Maybe not.
Whatever. Anyway, I have that song, because I love the song so much, so I just downloaded the song for it.
And Bernie Mac was on there.
Oh, my God, Bernie.
Did you ever see the original Ocean's 11?
No.
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
Yeah. Like they I think one of them dies and they all get away with the money by keeping it like in his coffin or something. That's and they cremate him, but somehow they get the money out of it.
That's crazy. They don't think
that's really good.
I don't have to watch the movie now.
Well, it has the Rat Pack in it, so. They actually had like little musical numbers in there every once in a while. So Sam Davis Jr. has this one song, EO 11. Sounds really cool.
I'm real. Well, now I don't have to watch it because you ruined it for me. So thank you, Greg.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So episode 11.
I try to be helpful like that, you know.
Awesome. A lot to cover in yet a little time.
So little time.
So we should just jump right into it. What's our first topic?
PAX East. We will be leaving for PAX East in 2 days, Friday? Friday.
We're leaving Friday, definitely.
Yeah, Friday morning.
Yeah. So all of tomorrow is actually going to be used up for packing and getting ready, everything sorted. So tomorrow there will not be a cosplay stream.
Oh.
Because we will.
Right.
That makes me sad.
No, I'm going to be working, so I probably won't even make it back in time to stream something.
What are you guys looking to do at PAX? Any excitement? Any besides after parties and hanging out?
Well, speaking of after parties, I want to make sure I want to try and get into the Twitch one on Friday night.
That's Friday?
That one's harder to get into. Especially for PAX East.
Why? Why is it so hard?
Because that's like the one to go to for the weekend.
Really?
Yeah. Every PAX, there's usually a Twitch party.
Yeah, and it's usually packed, isn't it?
So PAX South had a Twitch party, but it was really easy to get into because PAX South was a much smaller convention. So PAX East, being established for however many years already, much harder to get into.
Where do they have these Twitch parties?
I don't know. There's all these random venues scattered around the city, but I remember last year there was a huge concert and laser light show. And
wasn't Linkin Park there?
No, that was San Diego Comic Con.
Okay,
I remember that one.
Oh, that was San Diego.
Yeah,
I remember Linkin Park was at some, one of these events.
But aside from that, I'm looking forward to, I don't know, just talking to all my old buddies that I know there. So meeting up with them. There's a community manager panel going on Saturday. Learn some stuff there.
Apparently a picture counts as 25 characters on Twitter.
Wait, oh yeah, yeah.
Damn it.
You need to learn
You really need to...
You need to learn your...
get into Twitter. But, that's cool.
What are you going to be doing?
Me?
Hold on, actually. I want to play Overwatch, like... in a LAN setting. I think that would be cool because Blizzard's going to be there. They're always there.
Are you really think they're going to be like pushing Overwatch?
Yeah, it's there.
It's out in less than, or it's out in a month.
They have an advertisement on Battle.net.
Yeah.
Saying they're going to be there.
Yep, want to do that. Who else is going to? Battleborn's going to be there. I'd play it again just to play it again.
Did you play it at all during this beta? This past beta?
No.
So this past beta, I don't think we talked about it too much last week.
No.
They added story missions.
Okay.
So you could play two of the story missions. And they had more characters, but you had to unlock them all. Mm-hmm. So it like taught you how to unlock everybody in the game. And it was okay.
It was okay.
It was okay. Like, if I hadn't played games that I thought were more fun,
yeah,
in like the same kind of genre, I would be really down for it. But I played like Gigantic, and
yeah.
I played a lot of Smite, and I like that.
I like Battleborn more than Gigantic, though. I don't know.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I definitely liked Gigantic more. And I think that's because I found a character that I really liked, like from the get-go in Gigantic. Like, I love playing the ninja trip.
Mm-hmm.
I just run in there and like murder people. in Battleborn, I liked it a little bit more once I started playing Isaac.
Which was Isaac?
He's like this big robot dude. He's got a skull in his
in
his like cockpit, and he is super tanky.
Okay.
Like he's got a shield as his alternate weapon.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, he's got a shield as one of his abilities that deflects projectiles off of him. And like just those two abilities alone can keep you alive for a very, very long time. And his ultimate, he turns into like this tank, and you can keep it indefinitely. You just move very, very slowly.
Oh, okay. But so once you come out of it, do you lose it?
Yeah, once you come out of it, you lose it, and it goes into cooldown. So it's pretty cool. I really enjoy playing him.
Yeah. I didn't get a chance to look at the rest of the map for PAX East, but mm-hmm. I'd just be surprised or whatever.
Yeah.
Did you look at any panels?
No, just the community manager one is really the main one I'm looking at attending. That's on Saturday at like 3 or 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
It's an hour long.
Yeah, that was the only thing that I wanted to see.
Is it just basically telling you how to become a community manager?
Yeah, giving you tips on that and shit like that. Mm.
It's like a seminar.
Yeah.
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 That's pretty cool. I am... What am I looking to do? I'm looking to connect with old friends in the industry. I've been texting some of them periodically during the day.
Uh-huh.
My friend from Square Enix, I've been talking to him.
Yeah.
I think I want some swag. I'm getting to my old habits again of swag hunting.
Yeah.
So I want to see how much swag... I don't want garbage. Because I got rid of, like, a lot of garbage.
Okay.
No lanyards or anything like that. I want, like, swag. Like, if I can get a nice shirt or...
I don't know. My shirts always end up being garbage.
Got our tweet.
It depends on where you're going. I want to check out, definitely, Square Enix to see if they have any Final Fantasy 15 stuff left over from the stream that they did.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, their Final Fantasy event they had.
Yeah, so I want to see what exclusive stuff they have left over from that.
Okay.
Like I said, swag hunting. I want to try some demos. I want to see if Uncharted is there.
Is it? Yeah, Sony's going to be there, right?
Yeah.
Or where are they?
Sony doesn't usually have a big presence at PAX.
Microsoft does, though.
Microsoft has a decent presence at PAX.
It's going to have one this year.
Yeah?
Yeah, they're going to have the
I'm sure
Mirror's Edge demo there, I think.
If Sony does bring anything, I know Uncharted will be there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if they bring anything, Uncharted's going
to
be there.
Yeah, I definitely want to try and get some FaceTime with Uncharted.
Single. It might be a multiplayer demo.
Let's see if I can get some betas.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if I can get some... in some later beta. Like, whatever I can sign up for, I'm going to sign up for. I normally don't do all this stuff. But I'm only there one day, so I want to do as much stuff as possible.
Right.
I want to talk to people. I want to find out, how I can make our streams a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to.
So you're going to hang out at the Twitch booth?
I want to talk with them, connect, get some business cards, like network.
Yeah.
Yeah, like just do whatever I have to do to make our channel successful. So that's it.
Cool.
You're there. I'm only there one day, though.
Well, when we get there Friday, we're going to have breakfast, and then I'm going to head into the convention for a little bit. Just going to say hi to everyone.
You have a Friday pass?
I have all weekend pass.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. exhibitor.
Look at you.
I know.
Exhibiting.
Oh, that means you get to go in early then.
I get to skip the lines, yeah.
Yeah, you can skip the lines and just kind of, you can go in there while they're setting up and shit, too.
Yeah.
Well, most of them are done setting up. By the time
you get there, Friday.
Yeah, of course, but, and they have that extra time in the beginning of each day, though.
Yeah. Are there any exclusives there? I'm thinking about picking them up. Because We Love Fine, when I went to PAX South, they had that Transistor exclusive statue. Looked really good, but I wasn't like a Transistor fan. You're not a Transistor guy?
Oh, that game is so good, though.
I remember you were playing it.
Yeah, I beat it in like a day.
Yeah.
So it should be fun if any of our viewers or anyone are at
the Hugh day. Panda's going to be there.
Cool. Yeah, Hugh Panda's going to be there. And then we've got our friend that won the ticket.
Robert. Oh, Robert
won the giveaway.
Yeah.
So that'd be cool.
Yeah. He won it and then he stopped watching us.
Well, he's not home.
Oh, where is he?
He lives in, I don't tell this kid's business. He lives in Maryland.
Okay.
But he's up here now, and he's with his grandmother, and his grandmother doesn't have... He was just complaining that his grandmother doesn't have internet.
Oh, man.
So
wow.
He's stone aging.
Yeah. He just went back in time.
He brought his PlayStation up here with him to play online, and he can't.
They don't even have power.
Damn. Yeah, he got it. The blue period.
Yeah, he's using a crank to power his PS4.
He churn his own butter.
Yeah. Bad times that reached my high. But he hasn't stopped watching us. He just said tonight that he's gonna miss our show because he's not home. So
Okay.
All right, whatever.
Whatevs. But yeah, Greg, anything that besides what we said?
What I'm really looking forward to is what I'm looking forward to every time I go to PAX. I love talking to the indie developers there. I have a lot of fun talking to people that just like that made their own game. Where is Chuck? Is he okay? No, he's dead.
No, yeah, he died.
He's dead. He had too much takeout and died. But no, I love talking to the indie developers every time because they're out there. They've put their blood, sweat, and tears into this game, and now they're putting more of it into the game and bringing it out to these different conventions that people kind of judge it and all that. So I really enjoy talking to those guys. I'm interested in seeing more of that.
You know what's really cool? Tiny Build. Remember them last year?
Yeah, they're still going there.
They're going there, and they have like one of the larger booths now. Like they're getting big.
Yeah, man, that's so cool.
They did what was it? Party Hard.
Yeah.
And Speedrunners.
Yeah, and they had their other game, Boyd.
Boyd.
Yeah,
that didn't you take off too much.
You gonna catch PAX Pox?
You love PAX Pox. I caught PAX Pox the first year I went there.
2013?
Yeah, I got look really, really sick.
You have to bring some of that. I have one of mine, so I'll bring it this time. But the hand.
Yeah, I got the Sony one from when they went to PSX.
Oh, yeah. Those are cool. You have to have the hand sanitizer.
Yeah.
You know what we didn't talk about?
What?
VR. Is anyone interested in seeing some VR?
I'm interested in seeing it.
The line's going to be stank.
Yeah, that's my problem with VR at these conventions, because it's been at PAX for a couple of years. I haven't gone to it because the line's been so
ridiculous. The worst is when you go to get in the line, and they say, this is the end of the line, you have to come back at like 3 o'clock, and then you see a person who wasn't in the line,
yeah.
And you're like, oh, I thought it was cut off, and I tried to get in, and it's like...
Yeah.
I mean, it's very selective on who's manning it. Like, the dude who's there, who's the cutoff, who'll be like... All right, there's an opening, so it'll be like, come on in, or whatever. You never follow the timeline.
If you're gonna cut the line off. Like, don't let anyone else in. I don't want to come back. I don't want to do a loop around the place and then come back and see someone fresh in the line.
Never go to San Diego Comic Con then.
No.
Yeah.
That's the one.
I don't think I will go to San Diego Comic Con. Never go,
because if you're looking to get exclusives or be in line for it, and they'll cut off the line, and then. The dude will just be... You'll just be circling. They'll be like, you can't stand here. You gotta move. So you along with, like, hundreds of other people are gonna be circling That's around so the same thing. And then, when you pass by, you'll be slowing down.
And it might as well be musical chairs.
Yeah, it's exactly like that.
Flipside ND is asking what parties y'all going to.
Parties?
I want to try hitting up that IGN party, because... No one knows, guys. They're gonna do some stupid shit.
I don't know if I'm gonna go to any parties. Depending on how late I'm gonna be there. I registered, I guess if you want to say that, registered
for yeah, a couple parties. Yeah, I have like registries for.
Yeah, I RSVP'd.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
For a couple parties.
I did too.
What parties did we do? We did. We registered for the IGN one.
I'm definitely going to hit.
Was there
hit
a Battleborn one? Or was that the same thing?
What?
I think that's the same thing.
I think it's the same thing.
Which?
The Battleborn party.
Yeah, I think Battleborn sponsoring the IGN party.
Maybe. I'm definitely hitting up Acer or Asus. They're throwing a. Party.
Is he here? Flipside?
Yeah. Yeah, he's in the
oh, real dude. I don't think so. I think I'm coming back Saturday night unless Chuck makes me mad. Then I'll make him come home by himself as a punishment.
Oh, yeah. He has to come back early.
He has to come back to take his... I'm telling everyone's business. Like,
yeah, you are.
You can just, he just has to come
he
back.
He has to come
back.
Yeah,
for
he
family.
To, yeah, he has to come back early.
Boom.
But, yeah. I'm real, dude.
You want to join?
Yeah, you're, come on, yeah, sit in.
Come on. I'm just
going to ask special guests. No, don't ask, don't do that. Someone did that before. It was like, it almost set like my eyebrows on fire. Yeah. You have to get on camera. You have to get on camera.
What am I?
And cut the volume down, because I can hear myself squeaking. I'm squeaking. Is Link sick?
Can I see myself?
Yeah, he's sick. Oh, you sick?
Yeah.
Allergies?
No, fever.
Patch oh, okay. Pop?
He's got Pat's Pox
early. Pre-Pat's Pox.
Pre-Pat's Pox.
Sacrifice for
you move for Greg. With your knees.
He sacrificed himself.
What parties are you looking forward to, Mr. I'm in the other room texting. Like, I'll just show up.
Look at those chicken legs. His GLJ. Someone skipped leg day.
This guy.
Yeah, this guy skipped every leg day that possibly was.
He skipped everything. But hey, what parties are you looking forward to?
I don't know. I'm thinking of doing...
Black Sails?
No,
I know you'd be there.
Maybe a Square Enix party.
I didn't know
there was a Square Enix party.
I don't think so.
They just go out to eat afterwards.
Oh.
Yeah.
I heard it's going to be a Square Enix party.
We'll make him throw one.
We could.
We'll amp him up.
Yeah, he's the best man.
We've got enough people.
Yeah. The big ones are going to be the IGN and the Acer one.
Yeah.
Did you register?
The henchman props one.
Did you RSVP?
Do you have to RSVP for the
The pizza?
No, henchman, you pay $15 at the door.
At the door.
All right. Yeah. Same with Acer?
Acer, you just RSVP.
Acer, you RSVP. IGN, you RSVP.
Yeah, right. Those are free.
Are you going in your room with the whole pizza, you slob?
Pizza.
I want
pizza.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of buzz. Are you looking forward to any VR or any? Are you gonna get any of those lines?
If they're anything like PSX, I'm not even gonna bother. Those lines are gonna are retard long.
The VR will be out.
You know what you're gonna do? You're gonna spend the whole day.
You had to reserve.
Yeah.
A time slot on their app.
Prior.
You couldn't even. Yeah. Prior to it, you can't just be there and be like, "Oh, come on, man." They have schedule. Like, oh, this person's
what's
coming
up,
in at 3:30 or whatever. Yeah.
That's crazy.
So essentially, we were there. We were watching the lounge, and people just walked by.
Are you just watching people with the thing on their head doing this?
And unless you're within the industry or a journalist, then there's no way you can just walk there, wait, and go in.
That's horrible.
But if you were a journalist, then you'd just be like, hey, I'm with such and such.
We should
like,
totally get press passes for this.
No, that's what this is for. We're trying to get this big enough
so
we can do that.
We should be like,
step two.
We should already be at the
Greg,
level
you,
where we can get press passes.
You're jumping way ahead. All right, but that's cool.
Did you see that video? Me and Greg were watching it yesterday. There's a VR game for Paranormal Activity.
Yeah.
And Paranormal. This lady just freaked out and started... she crawled up into a ball and started crying.
Oh, didn't it show like the shadow of the thing beside her or whatever?
Great. I don't know.
No, like you turn around. Like there's this part where you go to an area. It like leads you to an area. And you can't go anywhere. So you're like, all right,
I
can't do anything there. Turn around and there's this thing that just pops up at you.
And she just like...
She screamed, like, fell to
I
the ground, was like huddled like in a fetal position.
And then they were like Paranormal Activity, the new movie.
See, I wasn't big on the VR, but the only thing that I really want to play in VR is scary games.
Yeah.
So, I was watching Jonah and Vasquez play with the Vibe, I think it's called?
Vibe.
It's Vibe with a V.
A Vibe.
Yeah.
He was playing this musical game. Where you can go on the SoundCloud or put your iPod on or whatever. But basically, the notes are coming at you, and it's like paint. and you hit like the notes with your paddle. But if you punch them, you get a lot higher points. And it had like this this Star Wars song about like Darth Vader on there with him. It was the funniest song I ever heard in my entire life. Like, I was laughing the whole time he was playing the song, and he played it twice.
Was it like I could barely walk after hip hop dropped all these names on the floor.
You can't walk into the next. I just said Jonah Vasquez.
Nice.
What name?
Jonah Vasquez. I don't know all of them.
Yeah, well, so. You know Greg. You know me. You know Pete.
You don't know Thornberry.
Who's that?
Thornberry. Yeah, you got Thornberry here.
One of our newbies.
The Devil.
The Devil's Cobra.
And we got Demaya.
The Roomie.
The Roomie.
The Roomie.
The Roomie.
He came from under those pillows.
He lives here.
He's the golem of the house.
He just popped up between the cushions.
Yes. With spare change.
Like Homer coming out of the bushes.
So that's cool. Are you guys looking forward to like seeing Boston itself?
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah. Because we're going to spend a little bit more time there this time.
I like the fact that we're there for PAX, and then I guess like a week later or that week, it's the Boston Marathon.
No, it already happened.
Oh, did it happen already? I thought it was
this past week.
I thought it was before, because like after we left the other pack, they had the bomb.
Yeah, it's different. It's different weeks. But there is.
Did they move it up?
What the
PAX is just later this year.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what's going on.
Yeah, PAX is later this year.
Okay, because I do know
last year was in March. The year before was early April.
I remember we went.
PAX is all over the fucking place.
I know.
I remember we went to PAX and that thing happened.
Yes.
And it was crazy, and I was like, "Thank God we got out of there." But like.
On Sunday, though, close to PAX, there's a Japanese festival.
So I'll probably hit that up
on the way back.
Nice to meet you, the Devil's Cobra 2.
Tamako.
Tamako? Is that Japanese?
Yeah.
Okay.
Japanese. Speaking of Japanese, perfect segue.
Ghost Greg Shills. Greg Way. Greg Way.
Perfect, Pete.
So...
Perfect.
Was that actually the next one on the list?
I think it was.
I'm pretty sure it was. It was like one of the top ones.
Yeah,
there you go. Okay, Ghost in the Shell.
Before we even get into this, race is always a heated issue. So these are our views. Well, this is my view, what I'm saying. My beliefs.
They are not representative of Nerds That Are Wrong With a Hole.
Yes. So
my words are mine and not that of my company.
Exactly. So if you disagree with me, you're more than welcome to disagree with my point of opinion. Yeah. Because when it comes to stuff like this, people always have different.
I disagree.
There you go. So he's a they announced the Ghost in the Shell movie. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They announced that the Snake Chick,
Scarlett Cobra.
I like how. Snake Chick is the first thing you think of when you think of Scarlett Johansson.
Not Black Widow.
Not Black Widow. Not her.
Well, I just saw.
not Lucy.
I just saw Jungle Book, so it's fresh in my head.
Which I gotta see.
It's amazing. Jungle Book. Amazing. Yeah,
I heard it's really good.
Amazing. I gave back my audition tape for.
Oh my God.
Shere Khan. Amazing. I'm gonna be in Hollywood soon. So anyway, so they came out with the. I guess it was a poster.
Yeah, it was a poster.
A teaser? I don't know what it was.
It was just a poster.
A flyer, a photo.
It's just a photo.
Of Scarlett Johansson dressed as the character. What's your name? I don't know her real name.
Motoko Kusanagi.
The Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah, the Major. Which is what they're going to refer to her as in the movie. They will not refer to her by her Japanese name.
The controversial part about this is that Scarlett Johansson is white.
Wait, she's white?
She's white.
Oh my
Wait,
God.
Playing.
I thought she was black.
Playing an Asian character? Now, when I look at the character, I do see a white girl. Is she Asian?
She's...
Yes.
What's her name?
No, well, I'm just saying. Like,
Motoko Kusanagi.
When I look at the character...
Her last name is Kusanagi, which is a reference to a famous sword in Japanese mythology.
Okay, but when I look at the character, I don't see a
Japanese...
So that's
Asian.
The thing, though.
Is Sailor Moon Asian?
Yes. Is it... She's a Japanese schoolgirl.
But she's a schoolgirl in Japan.
But she looks white.
That's the thing.
Are they Attack on Titan characterization? No, they're actually German.
They're mostly German, yeah. German. Except
I think Sailor Moon's white. I think you're wrong.
No, see, you're wrong.
I think
because
you're wrong.
What we do is we put our own racial identifiers on other cultures. And they don't do that. when a Japanese person draws a Japanese person, they don't make them look like what we think a Japanese person
is. So is Naruto like. Japanese?
Yes.
Yeah.
His name is...
Naruto?
Well, he's a ninja.
Rock Lee's a ninja.
Because Japan is a
country. Rock Lee is also Japanese.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Killer B's a ninja.
Killer B is a black Japanese. He's happy.
So,
that's what they call half.
The big controversy is that she's a white person playing a Japanese person, which there are a lot of Japanese actors out there that we don't know of that could probably play this part.
Well, there are also Japanese actors that we do know of that could play this part.
I think...
Like Rinko Kikuchi, which is the girl that played Mako in Pacific Rim.
Yes.
She would have been great, actually.
Yeah, she would have been perfect.
But how's her English?
Her English not great.
Exactly.
That's okay.
The one thing I think is you could approach it in two ways, and I'm approaching it more of the Max Landis way, which you've seen the video.
Yeah,
I've seen the video.
Where it's more... That decision was more on getting the movie made, because it is going to cost a lot, especially with the effects, and there's no A-list... Asian celebrity female who can push.
What happened to Lucy Liu?
Just money wise.
What about not Lucy Liu?
Lucy Liu.
Not Lucy Liu.
Which one is anywhere near the star power of ScarJo? But, yeah, exactly.
You got to whisper.
So it's almost as if either you get ScarJo in it to be able to get the funds for them to put the money out to make the movie, or we don't get the movie.
But the dangerous part of putting ScarJo Johansson in it is she just did that other movie where she turns into a flash drive.
Was that Lucy?
Which is kind of... It's not the same movie, but it's close.
That's also why they chose her, because of the similarities.
But they have Lucy 2 coming out.
But see, my problem with this whole thing, right, is that, one, there are no Japanese stars because they keep putting white people in the roles that Japanese people can play. Instead of putting Japanese people in it and building up a person, you're putting white people in it instead. And you keep using the same stars and recycling the same people.
But do you really want to risk a studio spending all that money and all that stuff on special effects? You put this movie in the theater, which I understand. And it bombs.
Lucy Liu, I think, got labeled difficult because of Charlie's Angels and her beef with Murray.
True. The second problem I have, though, is that...
They're all Chinese, though. I'm just saying. Except for Rinko Kikuchi. But Ming-Na and Lucy Liu are Chinese.
Yes.
Yeah. But they're Asian. Which,
no.
Then you're just...
That's also racist.
That's also for a
So the person has racist. To be Japanese?
I think so.
It would have to be Japanese.
There was a huge controversy from Zheng Shiyi playing a Japanese woman in Memoirs of a Geisha. Because she's Chinese.
Chinese and Japanese don't get along.
They don't.
I think
that's a huge controversy.
All right, so here's the thing.
But my second quarrel with this whole thing is that if you need a white person to push it forward, don't make the movie. Like, I don't think a Ghost in the Shell movie needs to happen.
So here's my
I don't think anyone ever asked for a Ghost in the Shell live action movie. I don't think it ever had to happen. I don't think the fan base really wants it. Because we already have good Ghost in the Shell movies or good Ghost in the Shell TV series.
Well, then that's drawn. That's gonna be determined then by the box office receipts.
Well, I fear now that the movie's not gonna make the money that it could have made because of this situation. Like, Asian people are gonna ban it, like not go see it. People and just aren't gonna go see it just because of the whitewashing.
But on the separate note, I think a lot more people are talking about it. Because of that,
people were talking about Batman Superman, and then like everyone went to see it, and then the word of mouth got out on how it actually really was, and then it just died. Now they're talking about putting the R-rated version in to make that money back up.
Yeah.
Re-release?
Yeah, the R-rated version.
Yeah, they're actually talking about re-releasing it in theaters.
The 4-hour version?
Yeah.
I think the 4-hour version would have actually made more sense.
Maybe.
I would not doubt it. 4-hour movie.
What, yeah, the ancient?
I would die.
But
yeah, the ancient one of Doctor Strange.
Maybe it won't feel so rushed.
What about
it? So the ancient one of Doctor Strange was originally an Asian man.
Yeah,
it's a Tibetan man.
And now it's a white woman.
Now it's a white woman.
I thought she was Asian.
No, it's a white girl.
No,
it happened so fast that I couldn't tell what she was.
Tilda Swinton.
Yeah. So here's my thing. They announced the Power Rangers movie, right?
Yeah.
So now this week they show what Rita looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rita is Asian on Power Rangers.
Yes.
She's also an alien.
She's Asian on Power Rangers.
She's an alien
played by an Asian. Her character is Asian on Power Rangers.
that's also because everyone on Power Rangers is Asian.
No, no, they're not.
Except when the Power Rangers are out of suit, because America stole the, well, not stole, but is using the original Power Rangers footage.
They did that for one, we had this discussion off camera.
Yeah, but they did that for one season. Also the season that Rita Repulsa was in.
That's how it started.
Yeah, but Rita Repulsa was in the all of it.
Yeah, but she started in those seasons where they stole, where they took Asian footage.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then they brought her, the actress, over.
But that's how it started.
Like, but it's the same thing. The character is Asian.
Yeah, but that show is literally the epitome of whitewashing.
There's a Black Ranger.
Not in a suit. Asian guy.
So it was white / blackwashing over Asian people. So
American,
yellow Ranger.
So my argument with you
and
is...
And it was still racist.
In the first season, they did have the Japanese footage. Whatever. Enough people complained about that. That the kids did learn martial arts.
Okay.
And then they actually did their own fight choreography.
So, you gotta try now.
Second season on with the actual people. So the argument is complacent. Because they changed the show after that.
I don't think that word means what you think it means.
You know what I mean.
I was about to say that.
Inconceivable.
Inconceivable.
Rita Repulsa in the first Power Ranger
movie was an Asian actress. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was.
Thank you. Please show them. What is this picture?
Oh.
I don't know. Calm down, Tamako.
He wants to see this picture.
It's a drawing of Scarlett Johansson.
Doing what?
Nothing.
Her face.
Scarlett Johansson.
Did he draw that?
She.
Oh, did she draw that?
Yeah.
Now could you make her Asian?
Yeah.
Like they were talking about doing with their CGI. Well,
did they
their
CGI her Asian?
Yeah.
Then that would only make it worse.
That would make it way worse.
So is this a big deal in Japan? Do they even care?
For the most part, no.
Japan doesn't.
So where is all this coming from? Here?
From here. The fan base in America.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. But the Japanese don't give a shit about the movie in general.
They're not going to see it. Yeah, they're not going to see it.
They're totally
because
not going to see it.
It's an American-made movie.
Yeah, it's an American-made movie about a Japanese.
They call that Godzilla too fat.
Yeah.
They don't care.
They don't like American movies for the most part. Some of them, they probably don't like American movies. They probably don't like American adaptations of Japanese stuff.
It still didn't. It did worse than Japan.
Oh, did it? Will you go see Ghost in the Shell?
I don't know, which is why I'm going to watch the...
I saw Lucy.
I would have been on stuff for
I saw Lucy.
I don't know for Ghost in the Shell, even before they cast anybody. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm not interested enough in Ghost in the Shell.
Okay.
See, I really like the series, but I don't have any interest in seeing a live-action movie of it. Like, I don't think that it's necessary.
But then there you go. Like, you didn't want to see it anyway, so then...
Yeah.
You're sort of removed from the equation.
Honestly, with Scarlett Johansson, I'm even less likely to see it. Because I don't think that she's good for the role.
So...
Minus the whitewashing. I don't think she's good for the role.
So let's say that everyone who loves Ghost in the Shell completely writes it off, doesn't want to see it. Then do you think Hollywood is actually, like, trying to get that audience? Probably not. They're gonna market it like the same way they marketed Lucy.
But if they don't, but if they don't want that audience,
then don't make
take that franchise. Don't take that name.
Well,
because the only reason you use that name is to get that audience.
So should they have renamed it, but use the same premise?
Yeah,
and then
sure.
People watch it and be like,
and they call
this
it Lucy.
Is Ghost in the Shell.
And call it Lucy.
Did you see what GLJVD said?
That's what you guys missed. China is a huge market, second only to the USA, so we have to deal with what they like to see.
Yeah, that's true. But I don't think that people who are fans of Ghost in the Shell, I don't think...
They'll watch it.
That they'll watch it. I don't
think
they'll be interested in it.
So you're like me. Well, I know of Ghost in the Shell because I know you guys
talk
about it all the
time. Ghost in the Shell was one of the first anime I ever watched.
But as a
Akira,
person who
Ghost
is not
Shell,
related
yeah.
to any of this, sees Scarlett Johansson, sees I assume it's a good premise because you guys like it.
What's up, Chuck?
In a trailer, and then I'll be like, I'm going to watch it. So it's the basic person that doesn't get into
that type
of culture.
To be honest, I don't think there are that many Ghost in the Shell fans around.
Yeah.
To say, like... Oh, Ghost in the Shell, that's a great franchise. I think that series is so far removed from anything good so far.
Yeah.
Or recently, that it's not, like, they made a really shitty free-to-play first-person shooter, which is absolute garbage.
And has nothing to do with Ghost Recon. I think the bulk of the people who are going to see this movie are going to have no idea this was from something else. Yeah. They're going to think this is just a brand new thing.
I think they could have just done a brand new freaking movie avoided the entire controversy behind this.
I saw Lucy, and the way I felt about Lucy after seeing that, I won't go see Ghost in the Shell.
Because of Lucy.
Because you didn't like Lucy?
I did not like Lucy.
But I love Lucy.
He was waiting. Did you stop?
You were totally waiting. Back out of the game with the coffee. He was like, this is my moment.
How long you were sitting on that one?
This is a tattoo.
I know. I can't believe they're making a Lucy 2.
Yeah.
It made enough money.
Why? It probably made money in China.
Speaking of money, this Jungle Book movie is so awesome. You go ahead and make the second one. I want to see what the second Jungle Book
is. Aren't they already making a second one?
They're making a British next one, year. I think.
It's a different iteration of it.
Yeah, it's got Benedict Cumberbatch in it, I think.
Good luck with that.
Yo,
it'll be cleaned up at the theater.
It's got stars in there. Andy Serkis is in that one.
Good luck with that.
Andy Serkis, they got Benedict Cumberbatch.
First of all, Andy Serkis is going to play the clown.
They got Benedict Cumberbatch after Doctor Strange in that?
Listen. Benedict Cumberbatch
is gonna clean up too.
And he's gonna play the clouds, the water, he's gonna a stick on the ground. Get out of here, bro.
He's gonna be every monkey.
And he's gonna want
to Oscar. This is just this.
He's gonna want an Oscar for everything.
I forgot who they got playing Baloo, but Baloo's a star too.
I don't care. Good luck with it. This movie is so good.
That movie's gonna clean up.
Lucy did $103 million North America.
And $290 million worldwide.
Oh, wow.
That worldwide, I bet you...
why?
Probably $200 million of that was China. If not more.
She turned it to a hard drive.
The $103 million is a yes.
Oh, whatever. I thought, like, outside of the U.S., but whatever.
Right.
But most of that, I bet...
The majority of the is gonna remaining be China. Is China, yeah.
That was Jungle Book.
Jungle Book.
Not Lucy. All
right, well then...
All right, thank God we were talking about Lucy. Jungle Book, of course.
I'm curious. Look at Lucy's numbers.
Could you give some Lucy numbers, bro?
I'm curious.
Pull
it up.
GLJVD.
Pull up our Lucy numbers.
What are the Green Lantern numbers?
No, I don't even want to see those.
Totally Green Lantern.
I don't even want to see those Lucy.
Did you hear that there was possibly a Green Lantern cameo in Justice League? Because at the end they had the jets fly by, and one of them flies away. Like, oh, that's Green Lantern. Get the fuck out of here. That wasn't Green Lantern.
Who cares?
Like, what? Uh-oh, here we go.
126 domestic, 336 million worldwide.
Now my question to you is,
I think that's not great, though.
Why? 126 million? Why? How much did it cost to make?
I feel like that's not great for... I don't know. I feel like that's kind of low.
It depends on how much it costs to make the film.
It didn't cost a lot, dude.
Yeah.
It probably cost a good
CG money. Probably cost
How much did it cost to make?
Can we get those numbers?
The last 30 minutes is pure CG of her turning into a USB drive.
Yeah, she turns to a USB stick.
She's Cortana?
Yeah. Could you tell us how much it cost to make, if you could look that up?
You know why it made that
40 million to make. That is
good. Oh, okay.
Oh, that's why they're making a sequel.
Yeah. Come on.
The math's there.
So bad.
Yeah, that's good enough then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I won't see Ghost of the Shell, but I will be seeing Power Rangers.
Really?
I will be seeing Power Rangers, bro.
I don't know.
I have to support the Power Rangers.
Listen, I don't think I'm going to watch it.
Jason David Frank, name drop right there, said he approves everything that's happening right now. He loves the green, but he's the Green Ranger, so he can't really.
Is he in it?
No, he's not in it. They have new people.
Of course he's not going to be in it. He might have a cameo or something.
Who's Zordon?
Patrick Stewart.
Oh, I'm watching this.
I'm joking. That was an awesome
one. I wouldn't put it past him, though. I think Patrick Stewart.
You know what I found out? That I didn't know?
Totally knew that.
The guy who did Alpha's voice was the guy who did Zim's voice from Invader Zim, which I didn't know.
Alfalfa?
Green Lantern did 116, but cost 200.
No one asked for those numbers.
Wait,
he asked for those numbers.
Do you know?
Green Lantern did 116.
Do you know that there? Do you know that? What's his name?
Because that suit, it was like a CG suit for the whole.
Do you know that Ryan Reynolds has four movies? Four movies where people try to abduct and take his body, and he swaps body with people.
Yes.
Is that a thing with him? Everyone wants to be Ryan Reynolds.
And I've seen it.
All four of them.
Why wouldn't you want to be Ryan Reynolds?
You know, speaking of abduct, I just saw Taken 3 today.
Oh my god, that movie was terrible.
What's the take?
It wasn't bad.
What's the taking one where he's on the plane? That
bad.
As a standalone, if they didn't make two prior ones, this would have been a
That guy's
movie.
Such a horrible father.
I don't know. Like, that last movie was pretty bad.
A stretch.
You watched it?
I didn't watch
it.
I watched it
in theaters, I think.
Oh god, well that's your problem.
But
if
someone
you
else
watch
bought the
it
ticket.
Casually at home, it's pretty good.
Someone else bought the ticket.
Doing some laundry?
It's a popcorn flick.
I didn't pay for that.
Yeah.
But it was bad. It was really bad.
It's like that Ride Along movie. And now The Rock has a movie with Kevin Hart. I feel like it's Ride Along like 4.
I can't believe that Ride Along was doing so well in reviews. That movie was like one of the worst comedies I've ever seen. I've never seen a movie that was so not funny before that.
Greg, you look baked on 420.
He would on 420. Just kidding. I don't smoke.
Why are we talking about terrible movies?
Because
that's the point. I don't know.
We kind of got into this.
We're talking about how bad Ghost in the Shell
is going to be.
It's going to be when it comes out and how it's going to.
What's
probably
up, Bob?
I think it's going to flop as well.
What, Ghost in the Shell?
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to do well.
I'll call you now.
Based on prior movies on this, yeah.
You think it's going to flop?
Yeah, probably.
Like,
when is it coming out? When is it coming out?
All right, so I'm going to be opposite now. I'm going to say it's not going to flop.
Wait, do we know when it's coming out?
You know what? We don't know the budget of this movie either.
Someone has to say it's not going to flop.
It could pull a Lucy and like be $40 million to make. But I feel like this movie has to be more expensive.
I feel like when Lucy came out, there was nothing in the theater. You know what someone said? I'm sorry, I'm all over the place. Someone said if Scarlett Johansson didn't play this part,
Mila Jovovich.
They said she would have played
it 20 years earlier.
Yeah, she would have played it, and everyone would have been fine with it.
Because she's.
I think having Mila Jovovich as the character would just solidify it.
How much?
She's not anything that's not a popcorn.
GLJVD. How much has the Resident Evil movies grossed?
Shit ton.
How much?
Give me those numbers. That many because they weren't making money. You know what I'm saying?
There's one more.
For what?
There's one more.
Yeah, I remember seeing something from another one.
Give me those. An army of her? Yes.
What did you even do?
Give me those Resident Evil numbers. Because how many of those movies she's made?
Six?
Yeah,
at least six.
They're the Fast and Furious movies of chick movies. That's what that is.
That's ridiculous.
A chick action movie.
Yeah.
It was like the same.
She fought Michelle.
Well, she banks off of that because she's like the original strong.
She's not even a character.
Didn't
they
start around the same time as like Underworld too?
No, she was on the same time.
Or was it before?
Fifth Element.
That was it.
Fifth Element. Okay.
The character she portrays isn't even in any of the games.
Fourth Kind.
Oh my god, the Fourth Kind.
The
abduction
alien.
Yeah, yeah.
That was creepy.
Fast and Furious needs to die. Fast and Furious does not need to die.
Oh, here we go. Give me the Resident Evil.
Oh, that's pretty shitty.
Wait, which one is this?
Resident Evil 1.
First Resident Evil. That's pretty bad.
No, 40 for 62.
That's
when she first started out.
She probably wasn't making a lot of money either.
And she wasn't a household name.
I did like that first one.
Let's go to Resident Evil 4. Let's go to the fourth one.
Apocalypse is 45. Look at that jump. And they barely spent any more money on it, too. So, look how much money they made. Saw an owl outside my house and shot out of
the
house.
The Guardians of Ahul?
The Fourth Kind.
Ahul. Who made that? Some high profile director made Guardians of Ahul.
Did that movie do well? I didn't watch that one.
I didn't watch it.
Extinction
made 50 domestic, 97. No budget info.
So it just keeps going.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Why?
It's the foreign one that goes up the most.
Who are going to watch these movies? Like, they're horrible.
People just want to see a stupid movie. That's why I watch Fast and Furious.
I feel like when these movies come out, there's nothing else in the theater.
Like, Fast and Furious.
Snyder did Guardians of Ahul.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Holy shit, really?
Yeah.
The movie's horrible.
You watched it?
Did you guys? I thought it's animated.
It's CG.
Yeah, I did. Of course I watched it. I watched anything see. Did you see?
Holy shit! Whoa. Yo, look at Afterlife.
Yo,
cost $60
so much. Why did that make so much goddamn
see,
money?
That was when they're like,
that's the
"All right, guys,
one?
This is our last one."
But they're making another one after that.
Oh, yeah. No, they made more.
Did you guys see?
God damn it. This had nothing
to do with what we're talking about, but I just want to bring it up because to me, it's a lie.
You're going
to
change the whole landscape of the conversation.
Did you see the Johnny Depp apology from Australia?
Oh, yeah, because
we're smuggling his dogs.
Smuggling the dogs. Yes, I saw it.
How funny was that?
I had not seen it.
Awkward.
It's important.
So Johnny Depp smuggled his dog. You have to get paperwork when you're putting animals into Australia.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
He was filming Pirates. He smuggled his dog in.
It dipped, but still, it did really well.
How much did, what's the vampire movie she did?
Underworld.
No. Who? She did a vampire movie where she rode bikes on the buildings. I watched
Ultraviolet?
Ultraviolet. Give me the Ultraviolet.
Oh, God. That was terrible. Oh, my God.
Who was in that? You didn't find out there were vampires to the end of the movie, which was horrible.
Who was in Ultraviolet?
Her,
wasn't it? And it was her constantly going through hallways and shooting.
And her wig kept changing.
I was someone else.
No, I was
could you give me,
you're thinking of AM.
Could you give me the Ultraviolet?
Aeon Flux, yeah. Who was that? Charlize Theron.
Oh, my God. That was horrible, dude.
Charlize Theron.
That was awful.
Last movie. Could you get the numbers for Ultraviolet?
Versus Aeon Flux.
Charlize Theron was like, all right, I'm going to do good movies from now on.
She still does a bad movie every once in a while.
Get those Ultraviolet.
Like Snow White and the Huntsman. Husband is at 30%.
Why is there another Huntsman? And why is it frozen?
I know, right?
That's what they're banking on.
It's like Frozen plus the Huntsman.
Super Frozen.
Dark Frozen.
Yeah, Dark Frozen.
Oh my God, dude. And it's like a prequel?
It's a prequel. Yep. Although I like Emily Blunt, though.
I do like Emily Blunt too, but
they're riding polar bears.
That movie looks really bad.
Well, here we go.
Wait, what number is that for?
Ultraviolet cost $30 million to make.
They just made it.
They hit it. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Oh man. Yeah,
they just made it.
That movie was so bad.
But I never saw
marketing costs.
So horrible. So bad.
So they lost money on that for sure.
I feel like
I'm sure the $30 million doesn't. I don't think it covers that.
I don't think so.
So they lost money on that.
Oh
for
my
sure.
God.
I feel like Aeon Flux and Ultraviolet came out at the same time.
They were around the same time.
Within a year of each other.
Yeah.
Same movie. Yeah.
They're basically the same fucking movie.
I feel like
they're basically the same.
They tried to do an equilibrium.
Equilibrium.
Crossover.
All right,
what's our next topic? That was a great conversation. Yeah. So in the end, like I said, I'm not going to go see... I can care less about Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah, I'm not going to see it unless it like releases a trailer.
I think what we should do, the Friday Ghost in the Shell come out, we just go get all the animes and we just watch them.
When Ghost in the Shell comes out, I will see it if there's nothing else.
There'll be something else.
No, the only way I'll see it is if they release a trailer and just blows me away.
What? Yeah. What like, if it's if actually
I,
good?
If I see that, I'm just
you
like,
know what looks
holy
really good?
Shit,
but I
wouldn't
Michelle.
Go
see
it. Go
what about
it.
The Total Recall remake?
That was awful.
That was bad.
But from the trailer, you can tell
it was bad.
Visually, it was visually stimulating.
I knew it was
going
to be bad, but you know, it had Jessica Biel and Kate Beckinsale in it. So
selling it on the ladies.
But like seeing the trailer, the backscape and the way everything looked visually, it looked amazing.
It did look amazing. I fell asleep during it.
That's how bad it was.
I watched the original recently. Yeah. Pretty decent movie. Like it's a decent dumb action movie.
No, it's really good.
Yeah,
but
that's what the 80s were.
But it's definitely dumb. Like it's really fucking
dumb.
Have
you ever seen Last Action Hero?
Yeah.
Amazing.
Oh, hold on.
That's my favorite.
Underworld cost $22 million, did 51 domestic.
Oh, they killed it.
$43 million foreign.
We're still on the movies, bro. We'll be
Evolution on was 62 domestic, 49 foreign.
Oh, they lost money on Evolution.
Was, yeah, Underworld went downhill after...
It went under.
And they're doing one more.
Yeah, they are doing one
yeah.
more.
Yeah.
You know what I love about Underworld, though?
Wait, no. There were a total of three Underworlds?
No, there were four.
There were four.
If you count the one that took place like early.
Yes.
Yeah.
Without Kate Beckinsale.
We got the Aeon Flux numbers, too.
King Kong was a terrible movie.
Holy shit, $62 million to make, did 25 domestic and 26 foreign. They didn't even make up the money they did on the movie.
So bad.
Which one?
Aeon Flux.
Oh.
Holy
you know
shit.
You know what they should do? Do they have it online? Like the marketable value of an actor? Because they do it sometimes in articles.
They say they need to make twice the budget to make profit.
The guy who did that video was saying how there's no more stars.
Max Landis.
Like, yes. there's only certain
there's
people
like,
that make...
There's like ten
people, A-list guys. Two blacks,
yes,
five women,
yeah,
and then the rest are like a couple guys.
So, I don't think there's five women that are.
He said five.
Yeah, he said there's five. I don't know if there's five.
I don't think there's five. I think there are more white men.
He's not talking about Sandra Bullock is gone. Like she doesn't exist.
Yeah, I feel like there are more white men.
What about the fat? What about the fat chick?
I don't know if she's big.
She's not an A-list celebrity. No.
Melissa McCarthy. No.
She has an audience.
She has an audience.
That Boss movie did a lot of money.
She has an audience, but she's not going to sell a movie. Yeah. Like her being in a movie is not going to sell.
She's the same Boss character movie. Every movie.
I think we got
she
three.
She is the same character.
Yeah, she is.
Three, right?
Right. Charlize, Scarlett Johansson, and Jennifer Lawrence.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say those three right now.
Sandra Bullock is still an A-list.
Is she? No, she's not.
No, she's not.
Because of Gravity?
Absolutely not.
Which I like, though. I like Gravity.
Yeah, I don't know. Sandra Bullock. I think she's on the fence. You can argue either way.
Tom Hanks is still. He's one of the dudes. He's one of the guys. Tom Hanks,
DiCaprio.
There's so many white guys that are in this list.
No, it's only a couple.
There's like eight of them.
Like George Clooney.
Michael Fassbender is now up there. I think
he's A-list.
I think so.
George Clooney
at this point.
No, Fassbender.
I don't know. I think Michael Fassbender. Yeah,
it's money.
Whoa, who's Michael Fassbender?
He's going to be...
Tom Cruise is still up there. He's Magneto in the new movies.
No, he can't sell a movie by himself.
Women fucking love him. Yeah, he can.
He can't sell a movie by himself.
Yes, he can.
That's why he's in X-Men. An ensemble.
I don't think he can sell a movie.
He can't. Whatever. He can't sell a movie.
I think he can sell a movie.
He can't. No, he can't.
You'll see with Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Compare him.
But that's a franchise.
Compare him. Look at him and then look at Brad Pitt.
Yeah, and then
Will Smith.
Tom Cruise is definitely up there.
Samuel Jackson.
No, Morgan Freeman, absolutely not.
Morgan Freeman can't.
Samuel Jackson is a supporting actor.
Yeah.
So it's Will Smith and...
he's right. Chris Pratt may be entering that.
Chris Pratt is there.
Yeah, he's like...
No, I don't know if he's there yet.
He's there.
I think he's outside of Guardians enough.
He's doing that movie, the Western movie, Magnificent Seven.
They're putting him fucking everything now.
Yeah, but he's there.
Yeah, Denzel is a fucking A-list.
He's a fucking A-list.
He's a twat.
And he plays the same guy.
Plays the same fucking character.
Except in Training Day.
You don't like Chris Pratt?
He's just a more angry version of the same character.
Because we love that guy.
He's different levels of angry in this movie.
In Training Day, he's just a more angry... In Training Day and Man on Fire, they're the same
character. If Chris Pratt... quote me on it. If Chris Pratt gets Indiana Jones, it's over.
Why? What do you mean it's
over? Because if he gets that role... That'll be his thing.
Yeah, no, that'll be his thing.
If he gets he'll be the A-list.
You know what they gotta do? Yeah. They gotta do a new Rush Hour with Keanu Reeves and Denzel Washington.
The Django Unchained, Jamie Foxx,
John Wick, and Equalizer.
Jamie Foxx still
no. No, absolutely not. He's supporting.
You don't think Jamie Foxx?
Nope. He's not an A-list.
Not anymore. Maybe between 2000 and 2010. Doesn't mean anything.
No, yeah, that's a while ago. It's like, what have you done for me lately, bro? Johnny Depp. He's losing it.
Johnny Depp has been in so many shitty Tim Burton movies that it's ruining his reputation.
He still brings in the money.
He does bring in the money.
Did Black Mass do well? I haven't watched it.
Even Robin Williams was losing it at the end. He was on television.
Yeah. I love Robin Williams.
I love the band too. I can only take him animated. I can't stand him in real life.
Really?
Like, yeah.
He's fucking hilarious.
I watch him do interviews and he's all over the place, dude. Like, I can't deal with
that. I love that, though.
You don't like that style?
Have you seen his stand-up?
I love Miss Jeannie.
Have you seen his stand-up?
I love
his stand-up. Is fucking on point.
Yeah, and he drinks a lot of water.
Yeah, he drinks a lot of water.
As a person who draws or wants to be an animator, he was the only person I wanted to work with
at one point. Depp hasn't had a huge hit in years, but what a... Yeah, tell me how well Black Mass did.
And then Pirates will come out and like crush everything. Stop it.
Fuck Pirates, though.
But Pirates isn't like...
I feel like Pirates doesn't have the audience anymore.
I'm going against Robin Williams. Get the fuck out.
But get the fuck... Yeah, really, get the fuck out.
Dude, I heard it's going to be the new Suicide Squad.
Oh my God.
Too soon?
Oh my God.
Too soon?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
He's coming back just to do the Suicide Squad.
Oh my God.
Last Pirates did bad.
Yeah.
How long ago was that?
Yeah, that was a while ago.
Years ago.
The last Pirates I saw was the second one.
Give me those pirate numbers, dude. You want to talk about Pirate Did Bad? Give me the last pirate movie number. And don't fudge them, Joe, because I know you.
All Alright, you think he's gonna fudge
me? He'll fudge him just to pull me, like, prove me wrong.
But I don't like the Pirates movies at all. But
I like I'm sorry, I'm Pirates of Star Wars on Warner. What are you talking about? The second one
was done. The first one was good. The second one was Stevie Jones' Locker?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I like the second one.
After I saw that, that British chick turn into a giant crab woman.
See that crab,
I was done.
I think that was the last one I saw.
Give me those pirate numbers.
I never watched the fourth one, though.
The fourth one wasn't good. It wasn't good at all. The mermaid thing.
Because they didn't even have the... They just had Johnny Depp. If they bring, that wasn't like the main
If they bring back Keira Knightley and Orlando Bloom, it would be... Who's dating Katy Perry, by the way?
I'm pretty sure Keira Knightley already said she's not going to be in the next one. I think they got Orlando Bloom, though.
Oh, did they?
I think they got him in it. I know Keira Knightley is not going to be in it.
Dude, they're making four Avatar movies.
They're filming it at the same time.
Four Avatar movies? Really? We really need four Avatar movies?
I still haven't watched the first
they're
one.
They're filming eight
and
hours
not,
of
and
it.
And not Aang.
How are they going to do it? Like, the first Avatar came out in 2009, 2010? Yeah. Like, how are you going to...
Did that movie really...
come out with a sequel?
Did Avatar really blow you away?
Years later.
They're filming it all now. 8 hours worth of movie and chopping it up. And
the landscape has changed so much since then. Like, how are you going to even...
Did you see what he said?
So here we go. Pirates.
Pirates 2 cost 220...
No, we said the last Pirates.
He's like, going through it.
He said compared to the other ones, he didn't do well.
He's being slick. That's what he's doing.
But that is...
That's a lot of money. Look at that foreign money. God damn.
That's right. Rolling in that Delray me. All right?
To be honest, humans after the first Avatar would just nuke Pandora. Yeah.
Yeah.
They turn Pandora into a
like,
music
station. How are you going to make... Are they going to rip off other Native American stories? They had Pocahontas and Dances of Wolves in the first movie.
Did that movie like really blow you away though?
The visual, I didn't watch it.
The visuals were cool.
Highest grossing movie.
The visuals were cool.
Is it still?
Yeah.
I thought something beat it.
I don't understand.
Star Wars didn't beat it.
I thought something beat it.
Nothing beat it.
Jurassic Park needs to beat it.
Jurassic Park's not gonna beat it.
I liked it. I didn't think it was a great like.
I wasn't blown away though. Like.
Plot-wise, because that it's been done. I just loved the aesthetics of it.
You're going to need VR for the new Avatar movies. That would sell it.
That shut up. You don't know anything about that, chat.
What is
your source?
Like, VR headsets in the theater? Because that would be kind of cool, actually.
Yeah. When they put that ponytail thing in there, you're like,
that ticket would be fucking expensive. Yeah. You're paying at least $20 in like a regular like, theater.
I would
pay...
to watch people watching in VR because that'd be fucking hilarious. Imagine a whole theater filled with people just like
Big Bang Theory. That's an awesome name, bro.
That's an awesome name. That's great.
The last hit for Johnny was Pirates 4. Everything after I'm gonna look up freaking Black Mass.
Well, he had Lone Ranger, which failed miserably.
Oh yeah, Lone Ranger. Like
was horrible. That was horrible.
Oh my god. I forgot about that movie.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god.
Who remembers that movie? I brought it up because of fucking Disney
Sweeney,
Infinity.
Was Sweeney Todd
after that?
Yeah, it was after Pirates. Sweeney Todd was after
that. even FPS Reflex is laughing.
Black Mass did bad. Well, you're not giving us numbers, dude. Don't fudge them.
I'm more interested in if they're a good movie or not rather than their numbers. Yeah.
And I never watched. He said Pirate 4 was the worst one, but yeah, he didn't give us any numbers for it. He just said it was.
He didn't give us numbers for it.
For Pirates 4?
It did awesome foreign.
So it did 53.
It did like 800 million foreign.
Wow. It did 53 million and only made 62. So that's not bad.
Which?
Man, this is a fucking
massive. It only made 62 million worldwide.
We're talking about movies, scroll up, slut. We're talking about movies that bombed, that people spent a lot of money on. Well, in this segment, this just came up because we were just talking about movies in general, and it just came up.
Well, Black Mask, it says it made $62 million in North America and $37 million in other territories. So, we'll say $100 million with a budget of $53 million. So, it's...
That's a success, right?
Successful. Not like... But that type of movie doesn't warrant, like, hundreds of millions of dollars. Because it's more of a, like, going for the award type of movie. Right?
Look it up, Takeout. Get out of here. He wants another number to
watch that. They have a rating for all the actors where it's a number
based on... A pay grade, right?
It's a number based on how many dollars you get back from every dollar you spend on them.
Right. So Robert Downey Jr., he's a A-lister.
He's A-lister. Oh, yeah. Everything, because of his off-screen personality, too, like he really
Which is crazy, because if you said that 20 years ago, 15
years
ago.
Movies, not TV shows.
He'd be in rehab.
Yeah.
Or detoxing.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's a huge turnaround. And I think
so did we ever find the other two women that are lingering that we didn't?
I don't think we did. We just started talking about dudes.
We didn't say it was Julia Roberts. She's gone. No. She's done. Gone.
Right now, it's Charlize Theron, Jennifer Lawrence, Scarlett Johansson.
The chick from Twilight.
No.
She's the highest paid actress in Hollywood.
She is not selling.
Yes, she is. She's the highest paid actress.
No, she's not.
No
way.
Yes, she
is. Jennifer Lawrence is.
No, she is. The chick with the best hair.
Kristen Stewart is not.
Yes, she is.
No fucking way. No.
I'm telling you, she is.
Still, I don't believe that. Regardless, she can't sell a movie.
I don't believe that.
You know why people watch Twilight? I'm gonna look
it up. Joe, give me those Kristen.
Because they like the stories and they wanted to see.
And you know what proved she can't sell a movie?
That American
Snow White.
No, no, that American whatchamacallit.
Oh, and yeah.
Every movie that she's been in. Every other movie.
She played the same character.
Is Hermione up? Nah.
She's not. Hermione's not like a...
No. She's a good actress, but she can't sell a movie. She can't
Natalie Portman?
No. She hasn't had a movie.
Mila Kunis?
Nope.
Who did Black Swan?
Natalie Portman and Mila Kunis?
As of 2013, she was no longer the highest paid actress.
Oh, she lost it? But she was the most highest paid.
Yeah, because Katniss came.
Yeah, see, Jennifer Lawrence is the highest paid actress.
Jennifer Lawrence.
Boom.
J-Law.
Thank you.
It's all about Leo. That's the, you know, female actor Leo.
Yeah, the Leo, the lion.
But, yeah, that's...
Yeah, it's because of Twilight. She had the Twilight movie, so she was getting paid money from that.
That's it.
She's
making bank.
That's all she had. She had no other movies A-list. That she did well.
The Rock is A-list.
The Rock can sell movies, yeah.
He can sell anything.
Yeah. The Rock can sell toothpaste with that smile.
And he started off shaky, too.
I know.
The Mummy Returns.
He still has some really bad movies.
Okay. Scorpion King.
Yeah,
Scorpion King was so
that's not Doom, even man. CG, man.
Doom. Not even the Scorpion King,
Dude,
but...
The Mummy 2, when he showed up with CG...
Yes. The Mummy 2, the Scorpion King.
Yeah.
I was like, that's it?
Oh. I went to see it, and like, oh my god, The Rock's going to be in it. First 5 minutes, and then the last 5 minutes.
Harrison Ford, game. What is this? Like, gross Harrison Ford. I was going to say Samuel L. Jackson made a lot of money, too, but that's because he's in everything.
Yeah, he takes any job.
Yeah, he takes pretty much every job now. Yeah. Dude, that Scorpion King movie was ass. Yes, it was. Scorpion King sequel?
You're talking about the one movie? That came on after that with those UFC fighters in it.
When they
those
didn't
are
even
ass.
Use The Rock.
Yeah, they didn't even use The Rock. That was
you know,
ass.
Always that's never made sense Kang. To me with the Scorpion King.
What?
So, in the Scorpion King movie, like The Rock is this nice ruler, apparently. It ends on him being a nice guy. But then in The Mummy 2, he's like... ruling, he's like taking over all these villages or whatever.
Oh, because they explained that. So when he was fighting with his army, all his people died, and then he almost died, and then he gave his soul to the desert king.
Yeah, but he was going around slaughtering people before.
Cameron
that.
Diaz is the first woman on the list.
Oh, interesting.
She is not. That she is done, dude. That's Justin's sloppy second. She's done.
At this point, yeah.
She's selling a. She was in booking last
but
week selling her
time.
Book.
That's all time.
She's a 12 and 2 by the way.
I think at this point, she's no longer an A-lister.
Scorpion King.
She was the Tooth Fairy. He had to start somewhere. He started with Disney and now can do anything that
he
wants.
He was the male Raven Simone.
And now he's going to be the Black Adam in Justice League.
That's going to be great.
Probably.
In one of the Justice League movies.
What about Ice Cube? Is Ice Cube a...
No.
No.
But Barbershop... How about the Barbershop gross this weekend?
I kind of want to see that, actually.
So, do you know some black people got mad because I was going to see Jungle Book and I wasn't going to see Barbershop?
Really?
So what happened was they had everyone in one line and they were like, oh, can all the Barbershop people get out of the line? So they got out of the line and looked at me and they were like, wait, what are you going to see? I'm like, Jungle Book? And they, like, and they gave me the dirtiest look. And I'm like, listen... It's in Africa, so I'm like, let's calm down.
Like, sorry, I watch good movies.
They gave me the dirtiest look because I wasn't going to see, like, the Barbershop 3.
No, apparently, I think the original Jungle Book had, like, racist undertones, so
did
there
it?
You go.
I don't know. I got
Do you think the people in line for Barbershop really researched into that?
No.
But these
that's racist.
These were some scary-looking black people. Though,
so my family was in the second Barbershop.
Like in the movie?
Yeah, they were extras in the movie.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
they were filming.
Like my aunt's like
in Patterson.
The house, and he's like
in Patterson. Last week they were filming Step Brothers 2. Boom,
23 million so far per barbershop. Well, I bet that movie cost like
$5 million. Well, none of that was my money.
I bet that movie made like cost.
Wait,
like $5 million,
we have to go see Barbershop on principle.
Okay.
I can't wait for The Rock to beat up a full grown man who can turn into a 12-year-old.
Shazam.
Well,
The Rock's campaigning for Black Adam to fight Superman for some reason now.
Even if Black Adam fights Superman, magic, right?
He'll be so much bigger.
That's gonna be right.
The Rock is larger.
Well, once McCollum got bigger, and then the suit didn't fit him.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
That doesn't matter. The Rock is fucking massive.
The Rock is as big as the real Superman. If Superman.
The Rock is fucking massive right now.
All
right,
what's our next subject? We've been on movies
also
way...
Also, The White Man's Burden. Yeah, I knew there was
way too long.
Yeah, we had it on that.
AKA Camden's little brother.
There you go.
What's next? Yeah, just video game stuff. Red Dead 2, apparently a map leaked.
Yeah, did you see that?
Where is it?
I don't know. Somewhere in the west.
The rumor is that it's a prequel to the other movie, the other game.
Yeah, because I saw like sketches of like Marston, and I was like, wait a minute.
Honestly, I don't think they should have gone back in time. I think they could have gone forward with something else, with another story.
Just something separate.
Yeah. I love Red Dead Redemption. It was one of the funnest games that I played in a long time. I like doing the shootouts in the street.
Yeah, I liked it a lot.
I like tying people to tracks.
Tying people to tracks was hilarious. Yeah. You know, every time some stupid hooker tried to steal my cash, they were on the tracks.
You're the evil.
The train hit her, I'd be like, you're attractive. That happened.
Well.
that's our show, everyone.
Next.
It's like the Animaniacs in here.
Roll credits.
Tough crowd.
Roll credits.
Star Fox comes out Friday, which I don't think is going to be great, and I'm not going to buy it.
They just couldn't bring back that.
Reviews are middling.
I'm not going to buy it because I don't think it's great.
Yeah. Are they really doing that Scorpion mythologies?
Scorpion?
Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
Where'd you read that at?
A movie? Or
no.
A game?
A game.
That's not true.
Like Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks?
Yes.
No, that's not true.
That game was kind of fun.
Let me nip this in the bud I'm not excited because it's not true. All right? Not true. Don't come here with your rumor mill stuff. I don't know anyone in NetherRealm.
Thanks for following Big Wang.
Big Wang? Big Wang theory.
Yeah, thanks for following Big Wang.
I don't have a Wii U. That sucks for you.
Did you ever, off topic but on topic of Big Wang theory's name, there was this Mad TV skit where people were going into like a porn office and like telling them their name. And then they kept on going. It was like really bad porn puns, whatever.
This Asian dude
comes in and he's like, my name is Hung Lo. And she's like, oh, that's fantastic. This is like the best name I've heard. You're going to make it big in this industry. And he was like, oh, so where do I go to take my picture for my driver's license?
What was this from?
Mad TV.
Which they're bringing back.
Are they?
They're bringing it back.
Oh, I miss
Microsoft is ending Xbox 360 production.
Yeah.
10-year anniversary.
Yeah, is there a 10-year anniversary? They're ending production on the Xbox 360.
So no more 360s?
No more 360s being made. No more new 360s being made.
Nope. Wow, that's big.
Yeah.
That's big. I'm hoping at the E3 this year they announce like smaller systems.
It's probably going to happen. And segueing to that, we've got the PlayStation 4K probably getting announced then.
Oh, that's the big... CPU and like
they got enough people with 4K TVs to warrant that.
Probably not, but it's probably going to be like for people that haven't upgraded their TVs.
PS4K.
I don't like that. There's these fucking half systems. Like,
oh yeah,
get a new fucking system.
Yeah,
just wait for it. Like, push it back. I don't want like a 4.5.
Yeah. Well, then instead of an Xbox One in 2013, you would have gotten it now.
Oh, it's because of the VR. That's why.
That's a rumor that it may be partially because of the VR and partially because of 4K, because they want to future proof it for 4K TVs.
Yeah.
And then possibly a more powerful processor to run VR without extra bullshit.
Is it a massive beta test?
Most likely. It's likely a massive beta test, a slim relaunch, and delay
the
inevitable PS5.
Did they just shut the online down for the PS2?
I don't know.
Yeah.
They shut that Final Fantasy game with the last game that people were playing on it.
Yeah.
They shut that down. The Wii U shut down there, like online.
Yeah, it won't run games at 4K resolution. It will run movies and stuff like that. So you can stream Netflix 4K on there, stuff like that.
Do I really need to see Daredevil in 4K?
That's Maybe not you, but
do I really need my retinas to burn out while I'm watching Daredevil? I'll go blind.
Yeah, and what I think is funny is that Microsoft has come out and said, oh, there won't be a Xbox 1.5, but then rumors and leaked spec sheets of a new Xbox have been released already.
They're probably just going to make it smaller.
No, the spec sheets are basically saying that it's going to have like PC upgradable parts, so you can take out parts and put new parts in.
Do I really want to do that, though? Like, that's work.
Buy a PC if you want to do that.
There you go.
The PS666 is going to be epic.
That's the devil. So, no, it's not. Stop watching Lucifer. That show sucks.
They might be giving MS a big opening. So they can have a more substantial upgrade. Yeah, so I don't think Microsoft's ready to announce their thing yet. Mm. But I think Sony will announce the PlayStation
4. I'm excited for E3 this year. E3. First of all, because all of us are going to be there. Second of all...
Which we got to work on as soon as we're back.
Well, I'll be there. Stop it. Second of all, I think there's going to be a lot of system announcements.
I feel what like.
What do you mean? I don't think
there's
going to be a lot of system announcements.
What systems? Nintendo NX.
The NX. The smaller Xbox, which is going to happen. I know it. Probably a newer PlayStation. Some better designed PlayStation. I feel like there's going to be some announcements.
Microsoft won't have you upgrade parts DS. Inside of the console, Greg. They now have external PCIe ports.
Yeah, I didn't say you opened it up.
Big attachments.
So they are gonna actually.
GLDB doesn't have research, bro.
So you don't open it.
Whatever, it doesn't matter. Void warranty. So we just buy a small box with a new GPU in it.
What's the cross?
Still, if you want to buy upgradable parts for your system,
just get a PC.
Buy a PC and upgrade your PC. Because that's gonna be the thing that has the most current technology. Even if you're upgrading on the Xbox, you're still behind.
Is anyone playing The Division?
Yes. Are you still playing?
I stopped. Like, no, there's no one playing. No one's playing it.
You got Takeout, right? You don't play it? Takeout doesn't play
it? Didn't anymore? They say, like, a ton of people are playing it, but they're playing it single player rather than
playing I've been playing it with Josh and Robin. We've been...
No, but like, I mean, religiously? Like,
nightly, yeah. They have daily missions where you get, like, credits to get the best gear. If you do the mission, you'll get, like, 10 credits.
Like a jacket?
Yeah, I stopped playing.
Like that?
Or? No. Like, the best... Items that give you the best stats.
Mm.
And then eventually you'll be able to play the Incursion, which is disappointing. It's basically a 15-wave horde mode. Unlike Destiny, where it's like a raid that you go through this whole...
Well, they said they were going to have raids. Level. They don't have raids now?
It was Incursions.
Oh, so that's what their raids end up being?
For now, I guess. Maybe they're coming out with something.
Probably if you guys complain right now, enough. That they'll change it.
Oh, everyone's complaining enough.
And there's apparently a bunch of shit going down now. There is a bug where you can get unlimited damage now.
Yeah, Division is garbage. Back in Destiny for me, it was bound to happen. Mobile gaming is getting too big for them to ignore.
I think it's all the upgrades.
Incursion is rough.
Chuck is writing like he's
They're not blind. Rough. I have friends who have beaten them. Chuck, get some better friends.
Yeah, get some better friends, dude.
I'd rather play Advanced Warfare than The Division. Bob Attack Man, have you played The Division?
I found that I'm not into games that have the loot, like, cycle.
Like an MMO?
Yeah. Yeah, I found I'm not really into those anymore.
But what about...
We've ascended as a people.
RPGs.
They have a story that goes with the loot cycle.
Oh, true. Yeah. I guess.
Give me the loot.
I'm a bad man. I love that song. But yeah, I don't know. Loot isn't enough to motivate me to play a game anymore.
I mean, it's good enough for me because I can play an hour at a time.
Yeah.
Because with Division, like the dailies don't take that long. I'll play it for an hour.
Someone wrote something in there. I just like the fact that you can play with your friends. And it's more like we can just talk about our day as we're playing. You know what I mean? It's communal, I guess.
Yeah.
What, the Division?
Yeah, like, that's all I use it for. It's like to shoot crap. And
April 26th, though, Rocket League is getting basketball version.
Is that that car game?
It's the car soccer game.
The soccer car game.
So instead of car soccer, it's going to be car basketball.
Is it a different game?
It's free DLC.
It's a pack for the actual game. Okay, yeah, that's pretty cool.
It's DLC for the game.
I may have to get Rocket League. But no one's playing on PS4. You guys are playing on Xbox.
He's got PS4.
Did you guys first play that at PAX?
He's not playing.
did I play Rocket League?
Yeah, what did you guys first play Rocket League?
It was a free game.
Free on PS4. Yeah. Before.
I think word of mouth, like, when it came out.
Yeah, once it came out, because it was free, everyone was like, you have to fucking play this game. And everyone's played the game, and it blew up tremendously. Yeah. And it sold very well on Steam. It sold well on Xbox. But I think
you guys started playing it after PAX last year.
I think it was free after PAX
last year. Which is why I thought you guys saw it at PAX, but I guess not.
Yeah, I think it was, like, the month after PAX, it was free. And now, is it cross? It's not. I don't think it's cross-platform.
It has
yet.
The ability to go cross-platform if the developers choose it to be.
Yeah, I don't think it's gone cross-platform yet, and they plan on making Rocket League one of the first to go cross-platform. But parties don't work cross-platform.
I know this is kind of off-topic, but did y'all play Batman: Arkham Knight? I have it. I should probably get on it.
The rumor.
But I want to.
Oh yeah,
the rumor mill.
HD.
Yeah, it's
collection.
That pretty much off? Known now.
Oh, go ahead.
The rumor is that they're making an HD collection of Batman Arkham Asylum and Arkham City. They're not doing the other one with
Origins.
Arkham Origins, because that wasn't made by
Rocksteady.
That was made by an outsourced place. But that's a rumor.
Rumor being someone from GameStop took a picture of it and then put it out online.
Yeah, and it should be available to pre-order tomorrow, I think.
That's the rumor.
First off, we don't say GS here. We say retailer. Third off, it's a rumor.
Say GameStop.
I don't support
them. None of us
them.
Work for such a company.
Exactly.
GameStop has no soul. All
right?
There you go.
Retail.
Oh, yeah.
I will never say those words.
I need one of those pins now.
I will never say those words out loud ever again. They get retailer from me. Retailer Swift.
You don't answer your phone.
Retailer Swift.
What happened?
You don't answer your phone, GameStop.
I did that once. I think you called me. Was it you who called me and I did that? Horrible.
Good stuff.
But yeah, the Batman games are really cool. I think I'm going to buy the...
GameStop is literally Hitler.
I think I'm going to buy the HD collection because I like Arkham.
The stupid long bridge you have to keep crossing over.
So, what would
PC and PS4 players get to play together. They've had crossplay since the beginning.
Street Fighter, it works perfect, dude. Like, I can't.
Street Fighter, no Final lag. Fantasy 14, and Rocket League, all games.
You do you remember PC. Shadowrun?
That game's hard.
Played that game.
No,
I know that dude played
Shadowrun.
It.
GLJVD.
Yeah, he played it.
I'm looking at you, Thornberry.
WB Montreal. Today is Hitler's birthday. Is it?
Oh, it is.
Wait, what
it's
happened?
Today is Hitler's birthday. Yeah.
Yes.
Happy 420 day.
So, yeah, the stupid... I know what you're talking about, Big Wang.
See? He loved fucking Shadowrun. It was good. Shadowrun was good.
Who? Wait, what? Shadowrun?
Yeah. Oh, GLJVD. Yeah.
Because it was cross-platform.
It was complex.
It was just all multiplayer.
I think they're making it a different way, though. Like, Shadowrun for the
What's
Xbox
the
was a multiplayer
it's just
game. Shadow Complex, or like the original series, was an RPG. I think the remaster is going to be the RPG version.
Not the
Complex is completely different from Shadowrun. Shadow Complex, wasn't that made by Epic?
Yeah, I think that's a different game.
That was a side-scroller.
Yeah, Shadowrun is
Shadowrun
like,
played like a freaking... FPS MMO
on the 360.
Yeah, because you had your tank, you had your range, you had.
But there
your...
was something else before that,
which is
where
what
it was a completely different.
Which is
game.
What everyone's doing now with these hero shooters.
Yeah, yeah.
It's exactly the fucking same. Like Overwatch,
both are
same thing.
Yeah,
and Battleborn, same kind of thing. And so it's got MOBA tendencies to it.
Yeah.
Shadow Complex is getting a remaster. Shadowrun isn't. Now I think Shadowrun.
Okay.
Not that Shadowrun game. But I think Shadowrun is getting another game.
They already came
That's
out
an
with
RPG,
the new one.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's on Steam. I think it's...
I heard
something,
it's good.
Some kind of Asian name attached to the end.
Yeah, I heard it's good.
Of it.
Oh yeah. My god, that freaking tree of life.
Wait, what? What?
I don't even remember this damn
tree of life, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
they
yeah.
They did a Kickstarter, I have it, yeah.
Is there anything that is coming out that you guys are looking forward to?
Overwatch is just Team Fortress 3.
Well, you talked about Epic. We've got Gears of War 4 coming out.
Is anyone playing the beta for that? Or?
No, I don't think anyone's having
Gears of War. I gotta play finish 3. I don't remember what happened.
I don't know if you guys...
I don't think we ever finished it.
I don't know if you guys follow him on...
My brother fell asleep?
Yeah. We were playing till like 5 or 6 in the morning.
I don't know if you guys... That lambent... Oh, God.
I'm so upset they're doing only two-player co-op this time.
Four. Oh, really?
From Gears of War.
Are they?
Gears of War 4 only is two-player co-op.
I don't know if you guys follow the guy who played Weather Wizard? But he's the main voice of the main character now.
Yeah, he's... Oh, you mean Liam McIntyre?
Yeah, he gives out beta keys.
Oh, like Billy C, how's Gears of War? How's Gears 4?
Tell us.
Yeah, let us know.
You should have been. I got an email with the code. It's downloading.
Or they change stuff for the worse.
Change stuff for the worse.
Oh my god.
I'm part of the podcast beta, Unlocked group, which is like an Xbox podcast. And a lot of people were talking about how it's just like roll, shotgun.
That's technically what Gears 4
was. That's what Gears anyway. Was before, but yeah.
I'm going to see Chainsaw Massacre Remake with Flipside.
Oh, that was the original Gears of War launch event.
Yeah.
We got to see Texas Chainsaw Massacre and when it right before it was aired, like it premiered.
Mm-hmm.
Saw the whole movie, got free popcorn, free soda. Afterwards, before the game came out, we got to play Gears of War on the actual theater screen.
Nice.
They gave us shirts and all kinds of
stuff. How did they cool. Did you have to wait this like line for that or?
The line wasn't even that long.
Uh-huh.
We just showed up.
That's weird.
Yeah.
What is Black Desert? I keep hearing
they don't do stuff.
It's
like
an MMO.
That.
Okay.
Yeah, and so a Korean MMO that's got some really in-depth character creation.
Hmm.
Well, you can change everything.
All right, so there's no stream tomorrow.
Because
the rest of this weekend.
Because
I think we're doing a special stream from there.
We're gonna try. I want to try.
You could try.
Try where?
You gotta bring the laptop though.
Yeah, sure. I'll bring the laptop.
Yeah.
Alright, so we may.
We're going to try to stream from the hotel room.
On what, Friday, Saturday day?
I would say Saturday, Sunday. So Friday, when PAX doesn't start yet for us.
So
most of us.
So for both days?
Yeah. We imagine.
Well, Pete can tell you what went on because he's going to infiltrate it.
Yeah, but he's going to be the one person.
For both those days of the stream?
Probably one of the days.
One of the days in the end day, they'll be.
Yeah. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and we'll
post it there.
You can position them to Hornberry.
Yes.
we'll post it on there before we go live on Twitch.
And if any of you guys are there and you have tickets for PAX, find us.
We might try streaming from our phones too, because apparently
Periscope?
Beyond Periscope, because you can apparently with certain streaming devices or certain streaming programs, you can stream it to Twitch from your phone.
Really?
Yeah, found that out today.
Sometimes also at PAX,
you need to research that.
Yeah,
or we could probably go to Twitch.
I found an app that you can do it on. It costs $1, but
we can go to Twitch and find out from them.
We are interested in cosplay, or at least the ladies are. They do.
I'll stop being cancer. Thanks, Bob.
Again, off topic. No. I mean, a lot of every Tuesday and Thursday, there's a cosplay stream normally.
Except for this Thursday.
Some type of creative stream, except for tomorrow because we're all going
to
be packed.
Someone told me there's not a link to our YouTube channel on the bottom.
Is that true?
That is true. I don't see it.
Yeah, that one right there.
Where?
In the About Us?
It's in the About Us.
Someone's a liar.
Well, they're saying it's not there.
Lies.
Where? Oh, there? Well,
yeah.
Who cares? Because it's a string.
You can't click that.
What do I know?
Oh, McRib is here.
McChibby.
And that's assigned to
McChibby.
If McChib is here, that means we gotta leave. That's the cutoff.
Yeah.
Party's over.
Yeah.
So follow us, like I said, on Twitter and Instagram. Check out our YouTube, which is mostly episodes of this. Yeah, what Moobot just said.
All Moobot. That kind of stuff.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Links in profile. You guys have any interviews set up at PAX? No.
Well, I'm going to bring the GoPro, so I'm going to take some footage and put together like maybe a music video.
If we really want to interview.
I have a GoPro too.
You have a GoPro too? When'd you get one?
Oh, you do?
For Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
You should bring it.
I feel like I know.
We can interview Will.
I actually am going to interview Will.
Oh, that's so cool.
Well, do you guys have a mic? Because the GoPro does not.
Well, the GoPro has a mic. It's just a piece.
I just needed to write a piece. I don't need to actually videotape
it. I want your YouTube in a more inconvenient place that I can't click. Okay. Well, then we'll just put it up here.
Yeah, we'll give you a more inconvenient YouTube link that you can't click. You're welcome.
The link's in profile. I like that. All right, guys. Again, another show under our belt. Episode 11?
Ocean's 11.
Oh, Legendary King Michael shows up, too.
Sorry, man. We're
sorry, dude.
But actually, I remember last year, if you were playing a demo of something, they would allow you to log in into your Twitch channel and stream the demo.
Oh, that's fucking cool.
So that could be a thing.
Could you see that could be a thing. Like I said, follow us on our things. Check us out when we're streaming, because we might do some random shit over the weekend.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, if you follow us, you'll get
an email saying feature.
Yeah,
yeah, a notification on your phone.
Notification that we're going to do something.
Yeah, and so I got set up too.
And a Polaroid.
If you have Periscope, we're gonna be Periscoping. Well, I'm gonna be Periscoping from my room.
And then we're going to rush home on Sunday night to watch Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones.
Do we rush home Sunday, or do we take it slow and just watch it on HBO Go?
Whatever. I'm going to be awake early on Monday.
I do.
This was a great... Okay, it's Wednesday. Thursday
night. And then we have to...
it is Wednesday.
And then we have to be crushed down for E3. Like, we have to buckle down on what's going to happen.
I think that PAX is going to set the tone for our other things. Because if we get this stream going on at PAX and this all works, you can do that at E3, you can do that at PAX TwitchCon, all that kind of shit.
PAX Polaroids?
Polaroids.
PAX Prime. Oh, PAX Prime. Polaroids?
Give these mofos
PAX Prime. When is PAX Prime? That's October? He's joking. He's trolling.
Trolling? Why are you always trolling, bro?
Polaroid pictures.
Shake it like pictures. A Polaroid picture. But yeah, it should be fun. Like I said, if you're there, find us. Please, please. Love to talk to you.
Everyone does.
Love to take pictures. Love to have you buy me lunch because I'm poor. I'm always looking for a free meal. And I guess we'll see you next Wednesday. Well, we'll see you from PAX.
We'll see you Monday or something. We'll see you sometime soon.
We'll see you soon.
Soon. All
right.
Multiplayer Monday on Monday. Check out, like I said, our social media.
From 11 to 3.
Figure out what we're going to do.
I don't know. But Jimmy later. Jones.
All right, guys. See you guys later. Bye.